Hello, everyone.
Hello.
Hello. Thank you for taking the time to join this session. I'm Yuichiro Sano, and I manage the Cloud Platform Department at Yahoo Japan. My team is responsible for support, promotion, and management of both PaaS and CaaS platforms on which we run our business. Over the past few years, we have learned many lessons operating platforms at scale. And in this presentation, I'd like to share some of those learnings with you today. But first, let me share a little bit more about our business. I'm sure you are all familiar with the Yahoo brand. Did you know we are the largest internet company in Japan? And we are growing fast. The whole country depends on Yahoo Japan services, so they must never go down. Let me give you some statistics so you can understand the scale of our business. 1 in 3 people in Japan actively use our services. That's 42 million people. We have a huge user base. And of course, this generates a lot of traffic. On average, we have 76 million page per view a month. This comes from a wide range of devices, from PC to smartphone to even to old-style flip phone. We provide over 100 different types of services to support Japanese consumers' lifestyle, from shopping to travel to career to auction to finance to news, and of course search. These services need to constantly change to meet consumer demand. So we have an engineering team of over 2,500 people constantly deliver new features. Engineering is priority for us. We aim to be one of the best technology companies in the world. Yahoo Japan has traditionally been a large user of OpenStack for virtualization. However, we had changes. Firstly, it still took quite a lot of operational support. On average, we had 2 operations staff for every 3 developers. We wanted to reduce this. Secondly, scaling on VM-based was slow and manual, and with which a large user base. We often have extreme usage spikes. So we wanted to move toward a content model that could support auto-scaling. PCS was a good fit because it could work with the existing OpenStack environment and provide auto-scaling out of the box. It was also able to automatically restart failed VMs and manage OpenStack infrastructure automatically through Bosch. This helps reduce ops cost. Finally, it allows our developers to spend more time just focusing on coding and not worry about installing middleware, etc. We saw the build back model in PCF would help us increase developer productivity. So let me tell you a little bit about the journey. We started evaluating PCF back in April 2015. We started with a number of pilots to do a detailed inspection of the platform capability, and then in October 2016, we actually released a pilot to production on PCF. Up until that release, we have resolved a number of issues we discussed. In the pilot and 6 months after the release of the pilot, we released the PCF platform itself to the enterprise as a GA product. Initially, this was deployed on one OpenStack cluster. We had a second cluster 6 months later. And then, 6 months after that, we add two more vSphere clusters. Currently, we have 6 clusters and AI count of over 11,000 in production. Let me share some more detail on the current cluster setup. We have 2 clusters supporting the sandbox for the platform management team. The development environment also operates on 2 clusters. We are currently consuming about 8,000 AI there, and this has the potential to increase to 10,000. For production, as previously mentioned, we have expanded to 6 clusters using 306 hypervisor and 900 Diego cells. In total, we have about 600,000 requests per second being serviced by apps running on PCF. And these apps are emitting about 19,000 log entries a second. Of course, PCF does not operate in isolation. We have a number of other services that are operating around the platform. Relational database, unified log management, on-premise image repository for packages for each dev language, Docker image, etc. Aside from that, for message queuing and rollback-based access, we have Parser and Ascens, 2 open source projects that we actively support. We also have path and key value store like Redis, etc. Our cloud platform team is part of the platform department. In addition to cloud platform team that is responsible for PCF, there are also other platform team. In parallel to the platform department, we have a separate infrastructure organization which manages and prevails internal infrastructure like networking, load balancing, IaaS, etc. My cloud platform department is responsible to both PaaS and CaaS platforms. Today, I'll be talking about the on-premise PaaS built with PCF. However, we also have a CaaS team which uses Kubernetes. This is not currently based on PCF. We have developed our own Kubernetes management system, which is operated as a single tenant system. I won't be talking about the CaaS platform today. At the start, there are a lot of beginners and skilled them up was big mission. We did a lot of internal seminars and hands-on seminars, including how to use basic PCF feature. We created Japanese language reference material and tutorials. We also use Pivotal consulting service to provide support for platform and SRE. Doing that, we are able to raise the skill level of beginners to a medium level. We also created an open service broker service to handle our Yahoo Japan cookies. As user increased, the migration of apps to the platform accelerated, and this created some new problems. We increased the number of production clusters to 4 to support the increase of users. As a result, the work to update build packs and the platform also increased. We improved this situation greatly by focusing on automation by the platform. Apps are moved to the platform faster than we initially expected. And as a result, we hit capacity and were enabled to deploy more apps. It took about 2 months to build out new cluster to further scale. We have now reduced cluster provisioning to 2 weeks through automation. Log data emitted from each app gets sent to an internal log server. We found that with the high volume of logging data, our log management system became overloaded. We also used Bosch to auto-manage VM-based logging components to help fix this problem, which I'll talk about later. We also found that if an application did not have timeout setting, it could affect GoRouter performance. Initially, we spent a lot of time dealing with questions from beginners, and this prevented us from working on introducing improvements. To fix this situation, we assigned clear roles and responsibilities to team members to make sure that also aborted time to improve stability, observability, and adding automation. This is how I have structured our past team with separate SRE and CRE team with clear responsibility for each. The CRE team focused on provisioning value to the engineer, while the SRE team is focused on increasing stability and reliability. Having this structure, with both of these teams cooperating together, we are able to make a big improvement to the value we deliver to the business. As I said, CR team mission is to focus on platform users, the engineers. There are three main responsibilities here. Firstly, to make the platform easy to use and developer more productive by developing and supporting common service broker service. Secondly, to be the contact point for developers to provide feedback and raise issues. The team is also responsible for proactively detecting problems with config, etc. Lastly, the team is responsible for user education, providing workshops and documenting best practices as well as provisioning architectural guidelines. The mission of SRE team is maximize system reliability. There are three big responsibilities. Firstly, defining SLO, SLAs, and defining alerts and monitoring schemas. To achieve those targets, the team is focused on supporting this proactively. Secondly, supporting requests from the CRE team. The CRE team gathers feedback from platform users and works with the SRE team to deliver improvements that deliver value. Lastly, the SRE team is also responsible for platform updates and new platform features. We always try to automate this as much as possible. Let's look at how the SRE team works in a bit more detail. First topic is automation. All the tasks are automated by the SRE team using Concourse. These are some of the things we automate. For example, we automate the build back of PCF clusters. Previously, it was a manual task of 20 steps, and now it's almost automated without any human improvement. Monthly updates to PCF and build back are also automated. Prometheus for monitoring. LogFada for integration to in-house log platform running on Bosch are all automated. Smoke test, which is used to validate the stability of clusters. Health check for IaaS, all of this is now automated. So let me show you some examples. This is the pipeline for PCF installation. As I mentioned, IaaS layer is managed by a different team, and this pipeline is after the IaaS provisioned. This automates the deployment of Ops Manager, Director, Elastic Runtime, and the time to execute the pipeline takes less than 1 day. This is a build back update pipeline. Updates are done for sandbox, dev, staging, and production. Users are automatically informed when the operation is complete. Yahoo Japan uses 8 build backs, and these are updated automatically every month. This is a PCF backup pipeline. For backup, we made a pipeline for BBR and execute it every day. Because it's not possible for developers to do a CF push when a BBR is executing. For the production environment, we backup each cluster one at a time so that there is no downtime. We execute smoke tests for all sandbox, dev, and production environments. We repeat it once every 10 minutes. In terms of what we execute for smoke tests, in addition to Cloud Foundry CF smoke tests, we also test the duration of CF push, CF delete, CF start, CF stop. If there are a lot of apps in a cluster, the CF push can become slower, so we test this for each cluster and make sure that the developer have a smooth experience with the platform. Next, I'd like to about monitoring. In order for the SRE team to provide proactive support, we collect a lot of metrics. In addition to obvious things like CPU memory, we also measure things like router performance, cell capacity, and logging system health. With this extra visibility, we can get on early sign. When there might be a problem about to occur, and we are able to respond proactively to resolve the issue before it becomes a major problem. We also use Prometheus and Splunk dashboard for monitoring. This is a dashboard for each cluster. For cluster health check, we monitor the condition of the main resource like total cell memory CPU usage, router performance, etc. With the multi-tenant environment, problem with the Go router performance can immediately affect the entire cluster. So we pay special attention to monitoring the health of the router. We primarily look at requests per second and latency. However, the number of Go routing can also have an impact on performance, so we also monitor that. This is cell capacity monitoring. We monitor both the total cell memory and the total cell disk usage for the cluster. Once total memory usage exceeds 70%, we provision more IaaS. This dashboard shows up latency. With 3,000 apps running in production, on very rare occasion, apps latency can degrade and can put pressure on the cluster router. If you look at average latency for cluster as a whole, it's not possible to detect this problem. So we found it's important to make 99 percentile data visible. This is a smoke test monitoring dashboard. We monitor CF push, CF start, CF scale, CF delete durations, and make sure the user have a good experience. Let me talk a little about logging related component. As I said before, the log traffic is around 19,000 entire a second. When application starts or move, log traffic can increase. Originally, we had the nozzle and relay components in a VM, which are restarted and scaled manually. We now use Bosch to manage this automatically, which has made it much easier to scale. This is the log monitoring dashboard. As I just discussed, the log components are shared resource for the entire cluster. If log data from an application increase dramatically, it can also affect the entire cluster. This dashboard clearly shows which apps are emitting the most log data. So if we see a big chance a change, we can ask the CRE team to look into it to see if an app is behaving abnormally. This dashboard shows if you have lost any log data due to heavy load. Logging data passes through multiple stages from apps to log data to nozzle to relay, so it's possible to be lost in multiple areas. We developed a single application that outputs 10 lines of log data second, which Splunk monitors. We can then confirm if log data has been lost or not, and display it on this dashboard. This is our SR team, how that works. We have seen a great benefit from automating the platform. The amount of time the SRE team spent on install and update work has been reduced by 18%, giving them more time to focus on other areas. We have also seen a reduction in events caused by human error. By automation the platform, we make it easier for everyone on the team work on everything, rather than specializing their knowledge on specific areas. What benefit have we seen from focusing on observability? We have found that time to identify problems has been reduced dramatically, and we have been able to move toward more proactive identification of potential issues. This in turn has contributed to the more stress-free work environment. Let's talk about the outcomes. In summary, let me give you some metrics on how things have changed over the past 18 months after moving to PCF. In terms of deployment, we have been able to reduce deployment time by 75%. This is an important metric for continuous delivery. Our process for provisioning new workspace now takes hours instead of weeks. In terms of scaling, as I already mentioned, we currently support over 600,000 transactions per second. And the platform can auto-scale in seconds where previously it would have taken much longer. So far, we have seen zero downtime, and since Bosch is managing the IaaS layer, VMware automatically recovered in minutes rather than hours. In terms of security, we have managed to increase the rate of patching 5 times, updating all bitbucks and the platform at least once a month. The time to apply patch across the platform has also been reduced down to about 4 hours. And finally, after only 18 months, we already have over 3,800 apps and 11,000 AIs in production. Last talk is future plan. So moving forward, we will be focusing on the following areas: doubling our clusters to 12, moving logging architecture towards an asynchronous queue-based model. As service broker support for all foundations, currently we only support this for 3, and continue to improve proactive operation to make SRE life easy and improve quality of service for users. This is all I have time to share with you today.